we know that if a function f is Riemann integrable, then the function f must be a real valued bounded function. That is, the function must be a bounded function. But all bounded functions need not be integrable. We will explain this with an example. So, example of a bounded function which is not Riemann integrable. Let us consider the function f from the closed interval a comma b to R, that is, f is a real valued bounded function defined on the closed interval a comma b. So it is a bounded function. Let P be the partition consisting of the partition points x0, x1, so on, xn, be any partition of the closed interval a comma b. Now we define a function f of x that is equals to 1. The value of f of x is 1 if x is rational number. That is, if x is equal to 0 or 1 or 1 by 3 or 2 by 5 or minus 3 by 8. If x is a rational number whose value will be 1. And the value of f of x is 0 if x is irrational. That is, if x is equal to root 2, minus root 2 or 1 by root 2 or minus root 3 by 8. These are all irrational values. For such values, the function f of x is always 0. And hence, f of x takes value from 0 to 1. It is true for every x belongs to the closed interval a comma b. That is, for all x belong to the closed interval a comma b. That means the function f of x is bounded. Now we are going to show that this function is not integrable, which is not Riemann integrable. Let us consider the lower dot box sum of the function f defined as f of x is equal to 1 if x is rational, f of x is equal to 0 if x is irrational. That is equals to, the lower Riemann sum is equals to sigma I is equal to 1 to n mi into delta I. We know that small mi is the infimum of the ith sub interval, delta I is the length of the ith sub interval. Here I is equal to 1 to n. So LPF is equals to m1 delta 1 plus m2 delta 2, so on, mn delta n. Clearly, m1 is the infimum of the function f of x in the first sub interval, which takes the value 0. So m1 is 0, m2 is 0, m3 is 0, mn is 0, into delta 1, into delta 2, so on, delta n. Now 0 is a common factor, take it out. 0 into delta 1 plus delta 2 plus delta 3, so on, delta n. Therefore, L of P comma F is equal to 0 into, we know that the sum of the length of the given sub interval is B minus A. Is B minus A. That is equal to 0. We can write directly 0. From this step, we can write L of P comma F is equal to 0. That is, if we take the supremum of all the lower Riemann sum, that is equal to 0. Because every value of L of P comma F is 0, and hence the supremum is also 0, let us call it as 1. That is, the lower Riemann integral value is 0. Now we are going to calculate upper Riemann integral. The upper Riemann sum is equals to sigma I is equal to 1 to n capital Mi into delta I, where capital Mi is the supremum of the ith sub interval and delta I is the length of the ith subinterval where I stands for 1, 2, 3 up to n. That is equals to capital M1 delta 1 plus capital M2 delta 2 so on capital Mn into delta n. What is M1? M1 is the supremum of the function f in the first subinterval. Similarly, M2 is supremum of the function f in the second subinterval. So on, Mn is the supremum of the nth subinterval. What are the values of M1, M2, M3, so on, Mn? Each value is equal to 1 because it is supremum. So, M1 is 1, M2 is 1, Mn is 1. So, 1 is a common factor, take it out. So, we get delta 1 plus delta 2, so on, delta n, that is sigma I equal to 1 to n delta I. And we know that the sum is b minus a, and hence 1 into b minus a is b minus a. That is the upper Riemann sum of the function f with respect to the given partition is b minus a. Now, the upper Riemann integral is equal to infimum of all the upper Riemann sum. And each Riemann sum takes the value b minus a. Therefore, the infimum is nothing but b minus a, that is equal to 2. Thus, the upper Riemann integral of f of x in the closed interval a comma b is b minus a. Thus, the lower Riemann integral of f in the closed interval a comma b is 0, whereas the upper Riemann integral of f in the closed interval a comma b is b minus a. That is, lower Riemann integral is not equal to upper Riemann integral. Therefore, this function f is not Riemann integrable. That shows that every real valued bounded function need not be integrable.